think it's safe to fly right now?
Where?
From US to Europe and all around Europe.
Well,
is it safe?
It's safe. If it's not, that's why the airspace was closed, to preserve the safety. Then now, when the authorities, they decided to reestablish the operations in Europe, that means that it is safe. I can assure you that.
Would you fly over Europe right now?
Yes.
You would fly right now over Europe? You have no
I haven't
no
flied, but if I have to fly, I will.
Okay.
The airlines have been somewhat critical. They said that they criticized the EU countries for moving too fast, but they said that ICAO should have coordinated in some way better. Is it what is ICAO's role in this? Is it just a forum for member states, or is it supposed to sort of take leadership and develop standards?
Let me answer your question immediately. It is the prerogative and the responsibility of each state to decide on the usage of their airspace. It is national considerations, but it is safety which is paramount. Now, I understand that the Airlines Association, given the amount of losses that they have had, were criticizing what they considered as being a too slow reaction on the part of some governments in Europe. But ICAO, as such, is not involved in this issue.
Let me add that there are several, nine stations in the world that we work together, ICAO and the meteorological organization, the Worldwide Meteorological Organization, and to monitor, specifically to monitor the volcanic ashes. And we provide information to the states, and the states, as the Secretary General mentioned, is the prerogative of the states, because they have to assure that the flights be safe. And the visibility is affected, and also the ashes can affect the airplanes.
Is there actual ashes that have affected? I had heard something about a military flight where the engine was affected. Is that a fact? And is that accurate? And is there?
There was a statement on the part of the military that some F-16 were affected by ashes.
Yes.
Now that the airspace is slowly being eased open, there is a concern by the airlines in the third world countries that in the first world they will not be allowed to use the airspace as easily as the airlines, their own airlines, like in England, British Airways, or Air France, or Lufthansa. Is there a mechanism to ensure that every airline, no matter where it comes from, gets the fair deal as far as using the airspace is concerned?
Well, all of these airlines, whatever they are, third world airlines or other airlines, have slots at the airports. So they can use their slots without any problem. I don't see discrimination here.
Can ICAO ensure that there's no discrimination?
Now, here also you have to understand, we are not mustering slots at the airport. What I'm saying to you is that the airlines which have slots at the airport cannot be discriminated, and then you give priority to national carriers. This is not possible. There are commercial agreements, and slots are provided to airlines.
Is there an altitude that is safer to flight?
It depends of the ashes. As I said, this is a monitor. We have to monitor. We monitor the ashes. We provide this information, but at the end, you have to land. This is the point. Because if it's only in one area in the air, well, we can have a contingency plan to surround this. But when you have it in the airport, this is the problem.
What about the control of the traffic, of the air traffic? Is it okay also with all these ashes?
It's perfectly controlled, but they cannot control airplanes inside of areas that the airplanes that cannot fly. This is the point. It's not a problem of control.
How accurate is your monitoring system in terms of assuring the public that things are safe? When you come in with your findings, are they really good? Can the public be really assured that you're giving something that's going to save lives? And secondly, I'm confused about what you're saying. You're saying that nations can decide what they want to do, or states can decide what they want to do. But airplanes travel between airspaces, so you're putting other countries in jeopardy if you're flying into a dangerous location. I don't understand why you don't play a more central role. Also, sir, or gentlemen, why are you coming and talking to us about this now when the volcanic eruption happened a long time ago? Is not your agency involved in trying to coordinate things between governments?
Let me be concrete. First, we came today here to discuss the three issues that I have mentioned to you. We were not coming to discuss ashes. We were coming to discuss the reconstruction of Haiti. We were coming to speak about the follow-up to COP15 and the preparation for COP16 in Mexico. We were coming to discuss aviation security. Now, the fact that there is an ash problem and a volcanic eruption is something which happened 5 days ago. And our appointment with the Secretary General was foreseen for some weeks ago. Now, coming back to your question, we, as President Kobe has explained, we gather all information related to ashes in 9 centers all over the world. One is in the United States, one is in Canada, another one is in Europe, London, 9. And we provide this information, which is a very accurate information. These are scientists. And then we provide it to the states. And then the states decide with this information, what do they do in terms of using their airspace? Now they take this decision with one consideration in mind, the safety of passengers. And then they have to decide if they close the whole of their airspace, part of the airspace, and that depends also on the category of planes which are flying. Some would be more amenable to fly in certain zones than others. So you have to take into consideration that this is not something that governments take hastily just like that. Some of them have reopened their airspace now only because it is safe. So when you are asking, would you fly? Of course I would fly if the airspace had been reopened. That means that there is no hazard or risk.
I understand that you had this appointment some days ago before the volcano erupted, but why talk about it now? The question wasn't you talking about with Ban Ki-moon today, just as a sidebar, as you make it sound, but why didn't you folks get in front of this many days ago when the volcano erupted? Because it seems like it is some sort of every government decided for themselves, every airline decided for themselves. It seemed like a lot of chaos, to be honest.
No, let me answer this question. I have to be clear, what is the role of ICAO? ICAO is not the operator of the airports. ICAO is not the organization that established the minimum meteorologic of the airports. And let me talk about that. The airport here in New York, John F. Kennedy, if it's a fog, the airport decides to close the operations because it's under the minimums and it's not safe. It's the airport, it's not ICAO, it's not...
With all due respect, this was an international crisis.
Yes.
It was an international crisis that was affecting the aviation industry worldwide. There was no central point. There seems to have been a major lack in coordination and a public that didn't understand what was happening, airlines that were indeed taking decisions for themselves and states taking decisions for themselves. But where was the cooperation? Who made the cooperation?
I think you have to understand what is the role of ICAO. Maybe this is the problem.
Maybe does the role of ICAO need to change to accommodate this? Or is there another entity that maybe should step in?
No one is questioning the fact, and you are absolutely right, that there was a crisis. No one is questioning the fact that a certain number of countries took a certain number of decisions which were not identical. But the situation was not identical too. Why should the Indian government take the same decision as the UK government? The situation was totally different. Whilst the Indian government was prejudiced because he cannot send his planes to London. So what you have also to understand is that even if you go to Europe, the EU itself was not able to find a solution to this problem, a coordinated solution or a unique solution immediately. Why? Because the situation in the south of Italy was not the same as in the north of France. So what you are considering as deplorable, and I can agree with you, is just a fact of life. All governments are not having the same attitude vis-à-vis a different problem. And we do not have a coordination role in this.